Hi Leo, I'm Anisha. To know more about my work, you may visit my website www.tarotbyanisha.com. For those of you who are seeking deeper clarity, be it in your love lives or your career, for a personal consultation, you may write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com. Leos, we have a major planetary movement that is happening this month. We have Venus that is moving, we have Mars that's moving, we have Jupiter that's moving twice, and we also have the cardinal cross that is being activated. Now we have Aries, Libra, Cancer, Capricorn, which are cardinal signs. Now while they will get affected, so will you. And the houses that are likely to get affected by this cardinal cross are your first house, your seventh house, your fourth house, and your tenth house. So there is just a need to be prioritizing things during the cardinal cross. On the fifth, we have Mars that is moving into your house of behind the scenes activities. And though this is a way, and Mars is not very happy being over here because it's a very quiet house, it's a house of spirituality, behind the scenes, research, and it's a house of service. And Mars being over there is like restless, you know, it wants action, it wants to do things. And this house is asking you to contemplate, it's asking you to go deep down inside your psyche, and it's really asking you what is it that you really want. And it can also at times bring about patterns, some psychological deep patterns that may not have been dealt with. It could be your childhood issues, it could be maybe your phobia of commitment, it could be anything, you know, which emotionally you have not been able to sort it out, or you may feel that you've sorted it out and it would just come up to the surface around this time. On the 6th, we have Venus that is moving into your house of career very briefly, and it's a time of accolades, it's a time where your work will get recognized, and some amount of credit for work done well is indicated. On the 7th, we have Mercury that is joining Sun in your house of groups of people and friends. So some of you could be taking a trip with your friends, you could be traveling, it's a type of bonding, sharing things, traveling together, discovering, going on an adventure, maybe being a part of a group that subscribe to the similar ideals and goals that you do. And it's just a time of sharing. It's a time also that you're being asked to seek a second opinion, Leos. Maybe there's something about your work that you can take a second opinion about. So do so, and that can be through your network of your friends. On the 9th, we have a full moon that is there in your house of creativity, love, romance, and children. And we also have Saturn over here. Now this has been giving you a bit of a tough time, but the good thing is Saturn is going to be moving out by the 22nd of October, so you're just about there. With full moon, it speaks about a creative project. Maybe there's something that is coming to an end, something that you enjoy doing, something that you've been passionate about, and it's coming to an end. It can also be that a certain situation with your child that you could have been battling with, it comes to an end, and you're finally sort of free, and you're, you know, breathing easy, and you're feeling that, okay, that's a huge relief, I can deal with this now. With Saturn, however, it tends to still make you still roll up your sleeves and work. So there's nothing to worry, you know, I think we all freak out when we hear Saturn. But the thing is that while full moon is indicating culmination of certain, whether it is work, project, creative, an issue with child, or even a lover or romance, Saturn over there is still saying, listen, there's still some work to be done. So don't be in a hurry to sort of, you know, pack your stuff and say, ha, okay, I can put my legs up. On the 22nd, we have Sun that is moving into your house of behind the scenes, and then Mercury moves to the same house as well. And finally, we have a new moon that is there in your house of behind the scenes. So your house of behind the scenes, spirituality, the house of service, it's also the house of undoing at times, Leos. It can be that we could be sabotaging our own happiness. You could be just coming in your own way. So try and sort of see, look at things carefully. Is there something that you can do that can be done to make your life more easy, more simpler, and you are not allowing it to happen, and you're not allowing it to manifest, and you're just somehow feeling adamant about it that no, you know, it is not there for whatever reason, conditioning or you're fairly convinced. So try not to sabotage your happiness. Stay flexible, stay open, look at all the ideas, explore. Even if it is something that you've not tried earlier, experiment with it and see. It's a house of service, a house of compassion. So lovely time to get associated with any NGOs, whether they are dog shelters, and go and just give, or maybe take your children over there. It's a lovely time of healing as well, Leos. It's been a pleasure speaking with you. I'll see you again soon, and thank you so much for watching.